Hey everybody, and welcome back to Gal. If you guys are new here, I make video, photo, and audio tutorials on this channel to help you create better video and content. So consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell so you're notified when I make new content. So this video is review and tutorial update video on a seamless transition pack that I reviewed last year in August. Then it was just 550 transitions, and now it has over 1,000 transitions as well as new color presets. So Replayer, the author of this pack, has been hard at work, and I'm going to review some of the updates and give you some more tips on how to use this pack. It hasn't changed in terms of usability. You can still have that awesome drag and drop feature, which is great, but there are three new categories of transitions. There is broken glass, kind of shattered glass transitions. There's also text transitions, over 80 of them. And there is the split and stripe transitions. Without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into Premiere and I'll show you how to use it. So after you download the Seamless Transitions pack, it will appear as a Premiere zip file like so. Just right click on it and open with the archive utility, or double click on it to unzip it. And the same goes for PC users. And once it's unzipped, it'll appear as just a Premiere folder. And within that folder, you will find all of the how-to help files, these PDFs, all of the footage that's used. And then each of these Premiere projects are the transition and presets as a Premiere Pro project file. And the reason why there are 14 of them is because there's 14 different aspect ratios. So if you want to use the full HD aspect ratio like I'm using, you'll first want to open this up to make sure all of the media is connected. So what we're going to do is double click to open this up in Premiere Pro. And once this is open, you're going to resave it and replace the existing project file. So go to Save As and then Save, and it will say, are you sure you want to replace it? And yes, we do, to ensure that the media is located correctly. So now there are two different ways that you can work with these transitions in future projects. The first way is you can actually save this as a template project file that you can start from every time you start a new project. So that way the presets here and the transitions are already imported and you don't have to worry about importing them. So to do that, I would just go up to File and Save As, and then I would create a new folder inside of this Premiere folder called Templates. And then I would just call this project template-transitions full HD. And you would do this for each different type of transition project here, and then hit save. And then this can be your starting go-to template project file that you can open up and then import your footage, your audio, and all of that before you start building out your project. The other way to work with these templates is by importing these transitions. So let's say you already have an existing Premiere Pro project file and you want to add these transitions to them. So to do that, first let's go ahead and close this project. And now let's say you have a new project and we're just going to call it demo, and we're going to save it into my project folder. So let's go to 1000 transitions and I'll just save it in here and call it demo. So let's say we have this new project here. It's completely empty. Now we want to import the full HD 1920 by 1080 transitions. So what we do is just drag this file here into the project panel. And then from here, from this import project dialog, you want to make sure to have create folder for imported projects selected and allow importing duplicate media, and make sure to select import entire project, then hit OK. So now you can see that it imported nicely into one folder here called transitions full HD, and inside is all of the presets and transitions. So if you toggle down here, you can see that all the transitions are here as sequences, okay? And you know, we can check out some of the other ones here just to be sure. Text transitions, see that all of them are here. Fantastic. But for the sake of this video, I want to open up the project file that contains that opening sequence so I can show you guys how to drag and drop the transitions and the color presets. So let's go ahead and open that up. So here we are inside of my demo project, and the seamless transitions are already imported because I started from that template project that I showed you how to create, so that way I didn't have to re-import all of the transitions. Now, the sequence I have open is the opening sequence from the beginning of the tutorial, and let me just play it for you. You can see that there are a couple moments where I do not have any transitions, as well as text appearing, and I will show you how to add a text transition. So let's just watch this through. So you can see the text just appears here. I am going to add a text transition here and show you how to apply that. But you can see that I've already added a nice zoom transition, a split screen transition, a spin transition, and a corner spin transition, which I think is pretty cool. Then a couple fast, flat movement transitions between the monkeys and the water shot here. And at the very end, I also added a nice little camera transition before my logo reveal. So between these two shots, let's go ahead and add a nice perspective in transition. So from the seamless transitions, let's open up the transitions folder and let's double click to open up the perspective folder. And inside of here, there are a bunch of other folders. Let's go ahead and open up the perspective in. And you can see that we get to preview what these transitions look like. And just make sure that you're on the icon view and you can use this slider to adjust the size. So let's see, perspective in right. I think I like the perspective in up. So what I'm going to do is make sure that V1 is off because we don't want to drag in this sample footage. We only want to drag in the transition effect. So just click on this effect, drag and drop it at this edit point, and see how it stays flush directly at this edit point. That is because I have the snap tool on. So you want to make sure that the snap tool is on. And then what we can do is just hit return to render. And it will just take a few moments to render out. And then we can see what it looks like. Let's play it back. Awesome. So that is the perspective in. Now at this moment, I want to add another transition between this waterfall shot and this swampy river shot. So I'm going to use one of the new transitions called glass transitions. So let's go ahead and open up this bin here. And let's open up the broken glass folder and let's preview a couple of these. So you can see it just has this nice kind of triangular glass shatter effect. So let's try the broken glass down. Let's go ahead and drag and drop this right to meet at this edit point between the two clips. And again, let's go ahead and hit return on our keyboard to render that out.
In the shallow, shallow, we're far from the shallow now.
So now that it's done rendering, let's go ahead and play this back to see how the perspective in and the shattered glass looks. Nice. What I really love about these transitions is that it comes already linked with awesome sound effects. So this glass effect comes with a shattered glass sound effect, and we didn't have to drag and drop the sound effect separately. It's automatically linked with the effect. So just listen again and you can hear. Pretty cool, right? So the last transition I wanted to add to make this opening sequence complete is a text spin transition on this transition layer. So let's go back to project and let's go ahead and open up the text transitions folder. And I want to apply a spin text transition and I'll do spin center and I'll change it to the icon view and magnify this so we could see it better. So I want to do the spin center counterclockwise and drag and drop this on the front end of the clip here. And let's do the same to the very end of the text clip, like so. So the problem here is that the background video is also spinning with the text and we only want the text to spin. So to fix this, we're going to lasso and select the transitions and notice how it also selects the sound effect with the transition and right click and select nest. And this is where you can choose a name. You could do text transition one and hit okay. And you can see automatically it nested it into one layer, kind of like a grouping. And so now when I scrub through this, you can see just the text is animating, not the background footage, and same at the very end as well. So the last step to making this complete is adding one of the new color presets, which acts like an adjustment layer. So let's go back to the project panel and let's go to color presets. And you can see there's three different packs, or cinematic one, cinematic two, and wedding pack. I'm going to use one of the cinematic warm packs. So let me just double click to open that up. And then I'll click on icon view. And let's go ahead and just apply cinematic warm one. So let's drag and drop this on top of the footage here. And let's roll the end of it out to meet the end of the sequence here just before the logo reveal. And everything below this layer here is affected by the color filter. So you'll notice if I turn this video layer 7 off and on again, you can see the effect. And same with the first shot as well, off and on. So now all of the clips kind of have the same sort of look and tone. And let's go ahead and render this out. And now let's play it back to see the full effect. So it's super easy to use this pack. If you have any questions on how to use it, be sure to leave a comment below. So that's all for the review. Again, I want to stress how useful these transitions are. I use them in almost every tutorial, every client video I use. It just adds that extra wow factor to the video that I've been looking for in a transition pack. Again, the link is in the description box below. It's available from VideoHive, which is part of the Envato market. Also, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you're notified when I publish new videos on the channel. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.